Now, the components of an atom are situated in various designation or, this is clip number 14. Now, the components of an atom are situated in various designated areas of the atom. The nucleus in the center, as we mentioned earlier, is the control center of an atom, and this is where the protons and neutrons hang out. Now, something mentioned at the beginning of this presentation is good to bring up here, and that's a quark. We don't know lots about quarks because our technology doesn't take us that far. But what we do know is that various types of quarks combine in certain ways to form neutrons and protons in the nucleus. It's like a whole little city going on in here. Now, quarks are made up of matter, again, as noted, because they're inside the atom. Now, outside the nucleus, again, is where the electrons hang out. They hang out in an electron cloud, and there are various levels to this. Ever heard of the situation of opposites attract? This has to do with a scientific term, because inside an atom, the electrons are negative, and the protons are positive. The electrons never go into the nucleus, but they're somehow strangely attracted to the positive protons. And again, opposites do attract, and this is what keeps them going. You can see these little things just floating around. I mean, not with the naked eye, but with an electron microscope. It's incredible. It really is. It's a whole city.